Everyone. Today we shall discuss chapter 3, probability. Probability means possibility or chance. Probability is the branch of mathematics concerning numerical descriptions of how likely an event is to occur. The probability of an event occurs between 0 and 1. Here, 0 indicates impossibility of the event and 1 indicates certainty. For example, when we roll a die, getting a number greater than 6 is an impossible event. And getting a natural number less than 7 is a certain event or sure event. Here, the probability of an impossible event is 0 and a sure event or certain event is 1. Therefore, probability of an event is a number which lies between 0 and 1. Before going to the problems, you should know the definitions and some important terms. A first experiment. An operation which can produce some well-defined outcomes is known as an experiment. There are two types of experiments. One is deterministic experiment. When repeated under identical conditions, the results or outcomes is always the same. For example, when blue litmus paper dipped in acid, it always turns red, and hence only one outcome. Random experiment. Any experiment that results in two or more outcomes is called a random experiment. For example, tossing a fair coin has two outcomes, that is head or tail. Drawing a card randomly from a pack of 52 cards. Any one of 52 cards. Rolling of a die has 6 outcomes. Any one of the numbers from 1 to 6. Next is sample space. The set of all possible outcomes of a random experiment is called as sample space and is generally denoted by capital S. In tossing of a fair coin, sample space is given as H, T. And when two fair coins are tossed, then the sample space will be the set HH, HT, TH, TT. In case of rolling a die, the sample space will be the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next, event. Any subset of a sample space is called an event. For example, in a single throw of a dice, the sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here, E is equal to 4, 5, 6 is a subset of S. Null event or impossible event. An event which does not contain any outcome is called a null event or impossible event. Example, getting a number greater than 6 in a single throw of a dice is an impossible event. Next is sure event or certain event. An event which contains all the outcomes equal to sample space is called sure event or certain event. Simple event. An event which has only one outcome is a simple event or elementary event. Example, in a single throw of die, getting a even prime number, that is E is equal to 2, is a simple event. Compound event. An event which has more than one outcome is called a compound event. Example, consider a random experiment in which two dice are rolled simultaneously, where the sample space is equal to 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, so on up to 1, 6, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, so it goes till 6, 6. Here, even is an event of getting the sum is equal to 6, that is 1, 5, 2, 4, 3, 3, 4, 2, 5, 1. This is a compound event. Another example, E2 is an event getting a doublet, that is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6, 6. This is also a compound event. Equally likely events. Two or more events are equally likely if they have equal chance of occurrence. Next, exhaustive events. The total number of possible outcomes of an experiment is known as exhaustive events. Example, in drawing a card from a pack of 52 cards, all the 52 cards are exhaustive events. Mutually exclusive events or disjoint events. If two events cannot occur simultaneously in a random experiment, then they are called mutually exclusive events. Example, consider the random experiment of throwing a die. Let E1, E2, E3 be three events such that E1 is equal to 135, that is getting a odd number. E2 is 246, getting a even number. E3 is equal to 235, that is event of getting a prime number. So clearly E1 intersection E2 is a null set, because there is no common element in E1 and E2. So E1 and E2 are disjoint sets, and E1 intersection E3 is not equal to null set, because E1 intersection E3, if you consider, you have 3 as a common element, 5 is also a common element. E2 intersection E3 is also not equal to null set. So E2 intersection E3, if you consider, 2 is common. So hence E1 and E2 are mutually exclusive events, but E1 and E3, E2 and E3 are not mutually exclusive. Independent events, events are said to be independent if the occurrence of one does not depend upon the occurrence of the other. Suppose an urn contains M red balls and N green balls. Two balls drawn from the urn, one after the other. If the ball drawn in the first draw is not replaced back in the bag, then two events of drawing the ball are dependent, because the first draw of the ball determines the probability of drawing the second ball. So if the ball drawn in the first draw is replaced back in the bag, then two events are independent, because first draw of a ball has no effect on the second draw. Next is complementary events. In a random experiment, let S be the sample space and let E be an event. E is a subset of S, but also E complement is also an event, so called the complementary of E. It is denoted by E bar or E dash, or also as not E. Example, in rolling a fair die, S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If E is equal to 2, 4, 6, that is getting a even number, then E complement is equal to 1, 3, 5, that is getting odd numbers other than even numbers. So it is clear that E union E complement is equal to sample space. Next is union and intersection of two events. If A and B are two events, then the occurrence of either A or B is known as union of two events, and occurrence of both A and B is known as intersection of events. Example, when a die is rolled, let the events A and B be A is equal to 135, B is equal to 123. Here A union B is equal to 1235. So write all the elements once. A intersection B is common elements you should write, that is 1 and 3. So there are three systematic approaches to the study of probability. One is classical or mathematical approach, next is a frequency approach or empirical approach, and axiomatic approach. But we will stick on to classical or mathematical approach. So let a random experiment have n equally likely, mutually exclusive and exhaustive outcomes. Let m of these outcomes be favorable to an event A, then probability of A is number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes, that is equal to m by n. And you should know the cards, about the playing cards. We have 52 cards, you can just see here. So 13 spades, black in color, 13 clubs, again black in color, 13 diamonds, red in color, and 13 hearts, again red in color. So here, in 13 spades are 13 clubs, 13 diamonds, and 13 hearts. So out of these 13 cards, 9 are numbered cards from 2 to 10. You can just see here, in all this, 9 are numbered cards from 2 to 10. One ace card, you can just see here, and 3 face cards. So 3 face cards are king, queen, and jack. So totally how many kings? So 4 kings. How many queens? Queen cards, that is 4. Jack, 4. Then ace, 4. So you should be knowing this.
and numbered cards. So 9 into 4, 36. So 26 black cards and 26 red cards. You should know all these formulae. Permutation combinations formulae is required to solve the sums. So once you can just go through NPR formula, permutation of like things, and combinations NCR formula, and probability. So I'm just giving you the list of formulae. T of A, M by N, and P of S is equal to 1, where S is sample space. B of A complement is equal to 1 minus P of A. Then P of A1 union A2 union so on up to union AN. P of A1 plus P of A2 so on up to P of AN for mutually exclusive events. And P of A union B is P of A plus P of B for mutually exclusive events. Now for non-exclusive, P of A union B is P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. And for conditional probability of B given A is P of B given A, that is P of A intersection B by P of A. Same way, conditional probability of A given B. And if A, B, C are independent events, then P of A intersection B intersection C is equal to P of A into P of B into P of C. So we'll start with the sums. Find the probability of getting a head in a throw of a coin. Solution: when you throw a coin, the sample space will be H comma T. You'll be getting either head or tail. So total number of cases, total number of cases is equal to n, that is equal to 2, and number of favorable cases, number of favorable cases, that is equal to m, that is equal to 1. Number of favorable cases of getting a head. Okay, so therefore the probability of getting a head is equal to m by n, that is equal to 1 by 2. So this will be the answer. So this can be asked for 1 mark. Next question: an unbiased die is rolled, find the probability of getting a multiple of 3 and the second one getting a prime number. Solution: the sample space will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Therefore, the cardinality of this set N of S is equal to 6. Subquestion A: let event A be getting a multiple of 3. So A is equal to 3, 6. N of A will be how many elements? You have 2 elements, 2. So therefore, the probability of A, that is getting a multiple of 3, is equal to N of A by N of S, that is equal to 2 by 6, that is equal to 1 by 3. Subquestion B: getting a prime number, let event B is getting a prime number, getting a prime number. So B is equal to, the prime numbers are 2, 3 and 5. So 2, 3 and 5. So n of b is equal to 3. Therefore, p of b is equal to n of b divided by n of s, that is equal to 3 divided by 6, 3 into 1, 3 into 2. So 1 by 2. So this is how you'll be solving this sum. So this may be asked for 2 marks. Next question. A card is drawn from a well-shuffled pack of 52 cards. Find the probability that, subquestion A, card drawn is red. Subquestion B, card drawn is queen. Subquestion C, card drawn is black and king. Subquestion D, card drawn is red and number card. Subquestion E, card drawn is either king or queen. The solution. So total number of cases. So total number of cases is equal to 52. Subquestion A. Subquestion A. 13 diamonds are red and 13 hearts are red. I need the red card here. Card drawn is red. So 13 diamonds. 13 diamonds are red. And 13 hearts are red. So number of red cards will be, number of red cards will be 26 divided by 26. Number of red cards will be 26. So therefore, the probability of getting a red card is equal to 26 divided by 52. So that is equal to 1 divided by 2. 1 by 2. Subquestion B, card drawn is queen. So there are 4 queens. 4 queen cards, right? Queens. So therefore, probability of getting queen is equal to 4 divided by 52, that is equal to 1 by 13. Next is C. Card drawn is black and king. So the king of spades and clubs are black. The king card of spade and club are black. So number of cards which is king and black will be equal to 2. So number of cards which is king and black, which is king and black, that is equal to 2. So therefore, the probability of getting king and black, that is m by n, so it is 2 by 52. This is n. So 2 by 52, that is equal to 1 by 26. The next is D. Card drawn is red and number card. So number of cards which are red and number cards. Number of cards which are red and number cards will be equal to 18. So there are 9 number cards, 9 number cards of heart and 9 number cards of diamonds are red. So therefore it is 18. 18 cards. Therefore probability of getting red and number card is equal to 18 by 52, that is 9 by 26. Next is last E. Card drawn is either king or queen. So there are 4 queens and 4 kings. There are 4 queens and 4 kings. Therefore, number of favorable cases will be is equal to 4 plus 4, 8. And probability of getting queen or king. So either king or queen, that is equal to 8 by 52. So 4 into 2, 4 into 1, 13. So this is how you'll be solving the sum. So if they ask 3 sub questions, they'll ask for 3 marks. If 2 sub questions are asked, they'll ask for 2 marks. Next question. A bag contains 6 white beads and 4 red beads. A bead is drawn at random. What is the probability that the bead drawn is white? Solution. The total number of beads in the bag. Total number of beads in the bag, that is equal to 6 plus 4. 6 white plus 4 red. 6 plus 4, that is equal to 10. So therefore n is equal to 10. And here the number of favorable cases, that is they have asked what is the probability that the bead drawn is white. So number of favorable cases will be in this, that is m is equal to 6. Therefore the probability of getting white bead is equal to m by n, that is equal to 6 by 10, that is equal to 3 by 5. 2 into 3, 2 into 5. Question. A box contains 8 red marbles, 6 green marbles and 10 pink marbles. One marble is drawn at random from box. What is the probability that the marble drawn is either red or Great. Solution. Total number of marbles is equal to 8 plus 6 plus 10. That is equal to 24. So therefore, n is equal to 24. So number of favorable cases. Number of favorable cases. So that is equal to, it is either red or green. Either red or green means it is 8 plus 6. That is equal to 14. So the probability of getting red or green marble, getting red or green marble, that is equal to 14 by 24, that is equal to 2 into 7, 2 into 12, 7 by 12. Yes, write down. Next. Two fair coins are tossed simultaneously. Find the probability of getting two heads, B at least one head, C exactly one head. The solution, sample space. Sample space, S is equal to TT, TH, HT, HH. So total number of cases, total number of cases, n is equal to 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So now sub question A, getting two heads. So I'll consider event A as event of getting two heads. So A is equal to H, getting two heads, only one you have. So number of favorable cases will be one in this case. So number of favorable case, number of favorable cases will be one. So therefore, the probability of getting two heads, the probability of getting two heads, P of A is equal to 1 divided by 4, M by N, so 1 by 4. So sub question B, getting at least one head, getting at least one head, getting at least one head. So B is equal to at least one head, TH, HT, HH. It can be more than one, therefore you should take HH also. So number of favorable cases in this is equal to 3. So therefore, P of B is equal to 3 divided by 4. Sub question C, let's see, is getting exactly one head. Getting exactly one head. So exactly one head is THHT. So the probability of C getting exactly one head, that is equal to 2 by 4, that is equal to 1 by 2. Make a note. question. Two dice are rolled simultaneously. Find the probability of getting a total of 9, B getting a doublet, C getting a total of 9 or 11, getting at least 1, 5. Solution. Here, sample space will be, you should consider the entire set, that is 1 1 1 2 1 3 1 4 1 5 1 6, then 2 1 2 2 2 3 2 4 2 5 2 6, 3 1 3 2 3 3 3 4 3 5 3 6, then 4 1 4 2 4 3 4 4 4 5 4 6, 5 1 5 2 5 3 5 4 5 5 5 6, 6 1 6 2 6 3 6 4 6 5 6 6. So totally you have 6 into 6 36. So total number of cases n of s, that is equal to 36. Sub question a, we get a total of 9 in following cases. Total of 9 in following cases. That is 3, 6, 3 plus 6, 9, 6, 3, then 5, 4, 4, 5. So therefore, the probability of getting total of 9 is equal to 4 by 36, that is equal to 1 by 9. And sub question B is getting a doublet. So we get doublet in following cases. This is 1 1 2 2 3 3 4 4 5 5 6 6. So therefore the probability of getting a doublet is equal to total 6, you have 6 divided by 36, 1 by 6, 6 into 1, 6 into 6. C, getting a total of 9 or 11. So we get total of 9 or 11 in following cases. That is 3 6 6 3 5 4 4 5 6 5 and 5 6. So 9 or 11, 3 6 9 6 3 9 5 plus 4 9 4 plus 5 9 6 plus 5 11 5 plus 6 11. Therefore, probability of getting 9 or 11 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 divided by 36. Again, that is equal to 1 by 6. The last one, getting at least 1 phi. Getting at least 1 phi. So we get at least 1 phi. At least 1 phi in following cases. That is 1 phi, phi 1, 2 phi, phi 2, 3 phi, phi 3, 4 phi, phi 4, 5 phi, 6 phi, and 5 6. So totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So favorable cases will be 11. Therefore, probability of getting at least 1 phi is equal to 11 by 36. 11 by 36. Next question. Two cards are drawn from a well-shuffled pack of playing cards. Find the probability that subquestion A, both are same color. Subquestion B, both belong to same suit. Subquestion C, both are ace. Subquestion D, one queen and one king. Solution. In this total number of cases, total number of cases will be 52 C2, because two cards are drawn from a well shuffled pack of playing cards. So total number of cases will be equal to 52 C2. So total number of cases will be 52 C2. So 52 C2 value will be 52 into 51 divided by 2. NC2 is n into n minus 1 by 2. So you should remember this result. We often use this. So 52 into 51 by 2, the answer will be 1326. Subquestion A, both are red and both are black. So when both are red and both are black, so both are red and both are black. Both are of same color. So therefore, number of favorable cases, that is M, that is equal to 26 C2 plus 26 C2. Because 26 cards are red and 26 cards are black. So it is 26 C2 plus 26 C2. Therefore, the probability of getting same color is equal to 26 C2 plus 26 C2 divided by 52 C2. So that is equal to 26 into 25 by 2. So by 2 plus 26 into 25 by 2. So that's repeated. So I will just write it as into 2 divided by 52 C2. It's already found out. So 1326. So this value is 650 divided by 1326. You can also write it as 0.4902. Subquestion B, both are spades or both are clubs or both are diamonds or both are hearts, both belong to same suit. So therefore, the total number of favorable cases will be total number of favorable cases will be 13C2 plus 13C2 plus 13C2 plus 13C2. So therefore, P of both belong to same suit, both from same suit. So that is equal to 4 into, so 4 times it is 4 into 13C2 divided by 52C2. So that value is 4 into 13 into 12 by 2 divided by 1326. So you can just cancel this 2 into 1. Then 2 into 2. So you can calculate and you'll be getting the answer as 4 by 17. C. Both are A's. So both are A's means number of favorable cases. So number of favorable cases is equal to 4C2. So P of both are A's is equal to 4C2 divided by 52C2. So that is equal to 4C2, so value is 6 by 6 divided by 1326. So that is equal to 1 by 6 into 1, 6 into 2, 2, 1, 1 by 221. So the last is D, one queen and one king. So one queen and one king can be chosen in 4C1 into 4C1 ways. One queen and one king can be chosen in 4C1 into 4C1 ways. Therefore, the probability of choosing one Q and one King is equal to 4C1 into 4C1 divided by 52C2. So that is equal to 4 into 4 divided by 1326. So that is 4, 2, 6, 63. So it is 4 into 2, 8 by 663. 8 by 663 will be the answer. Next question. Three fair coins are tossed simultaneously. Find the probability of subquestion A getting one head, subquestion B getting at least two heads, subquestion C getting at most one head. Solution. Sample space S is equal to, that is HHH HHT HTT THH THT THT TTT 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So N of S is equal to 8. Subquestion A getting one head. So A, the event A, I'll get it, take it as getting one head. So A is equal to HTT THT TTH. So you can just see here. So HTT THT TTH. So this is N of A. I'll get it as 3. So P of A will be the number of favorable cases will be 3 divided by total number of cases by 8. So 3 by 8. Subquestion B, getting at least 2 hits. So B I will consider it as getting at least 2 hits. So B equal to HHH HHT, at least 2 hits. So it can be more than 2. HTH THH. So therefore probability of B is favorable cases, total number of favorable cases, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, divided by total number of cases, that is 8, 1 by 2. Last subquestion C, getting at most 1 hit. C, getting at most 1 head. So C is equal to at most 1 head means 1 head and no head. So TTT HTT THT TTH. So the probability of getting at most 1 head P of C, that is equal to 2, 3, 4, 4 divided by 8, that is again equal to 1 by 2. Yes. Next question. A bag has 15 tickets numbered from 1 to 15. 2 tickets are drawn at random from the bag. Find the probability that both the numbers drawn are odd and subquestion B prime. Solution. Subquestion A. So odd numbers. Odd numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. So number of favorable cases is number of favorable cases 8C2. So therefore the probability of getting both odd numbers, so that is equal to 8C2 divided by 15C2. So the value is 8 into 7 by 2 divided by 15 into 14 by 2. So we'll be getting it as, so again 28, by simplify 28 by 105, then again that is equal to 4 by 7 to 4, 7 to 15, so 4 by 15. So here you can cancel 2 into 4, 2 into 7. 2 into 4, 2 into 7. So the next is B. Subquestion B. Prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13. So therefore, number of favorable cases is equal to 6C2. therefore p of both probability of getting both prime numbers is equal to 6c2 divided by 15c2, 16 to 5 by 2 divided by 15 into 14 by 2. So again, 5 into 1, 5 into 3, 3 into 1, 3 into 2, 2 into 1, 2 into 7. So you can just cancel 5 into 1, 5 into 3, 3 into 1, 3 into 2, 2 into 1, 2 into 7. So that is equal to 1 by 7. Next question. A bag contains 5 red, 7 yellow and 8 green marbles. 3 marbles are drawn randomly from the bag. What is the probability that all the 3 are red? Subquestion B, all the 3 are same color. Subquestion C, they are of different 3 different colors. Solution. So total marbles, that is total is 5 plus 7 plus 8. So there are 20 marbles. So total ways of drawing 3 marbles from 20 marbles. Total ways of drawing 3 marbles from 20 marbles is equal to 20C3. Subquestion A, all the 3 are red. All the 3 are red means the number of favorable cases will be number of favorable cases of getting all the 3 marbles red, that is equal to 5C3. So there are 5 red marbles, so it is 5C3. So probability of getting all 3 are red, all 3 red, so that is equal to 5C3 divided by 20C3. So when you calculate this, you'll be getting the solution as 1 by 114. So you simplify this and get the answer. The next question, subquestion B, all the 3 are of same color. All 3 are same color. All 3 are red. All 3 are red. Or all 3 are yellow, or all 3 are green. So number of favorable cases. Number of favorable cases is equal to 5C3 plus 7C3 plus 8C3. So therefore, probability of getting all 3 same color is equal to 5C3 plus 7C3 plus 8C3 divided by 20C3, that is equal to 5C3 is 10 plus 7C3 is 35 plus 8C3 is 56 divided by 20C3 is 1140. So therefore, that is equal to 101 divided by 1140. So this is how you calculate.
Subquestion C, they are of different color, that is one red and one yellow and one green marble is drawn. So therefore, total number of favorable cases is equal to 5C1 into 7C1 into 8C1. Therefore, the probability of drawing three different colored marbles. That is equal to 5C1 into 7C1 into 8C1 divided by 20C3. That is equal to 5 into 7 into 8 divided by 1140. So if you simplify this further, you will be getting 4 into 2. This is 4 into 2, 4, 8, 32, then 4 into 5. So again, 5 into 1, 5 into 5, 7. So that is equal to 14 by 57. By this, we have completed around 11 sums. Next class, we will solve few more sums. Thank you.